Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over what to do when you encounter various errors inside of Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I am on our blog. I'm going to include this link to our blog in the description below if you would like to come back here. But I just want to show you this list that we've provided of different kinds of errors you sometimes get when you're using Microsoft Excel. And I'm going to show you an example of a couple of these, but if you would like more in-depth information about this, please visit our blog. So let's go over the ref, the value, and the divide by zero error. So here I have a spreadsheet in Excel. And the first kind of error I want to show you is the value error. So if I type equals, and let's say I pick any kind of text field in here. So I'm just going to pick this one and try to add 12 to a text field. And if I hit enter, you can see that I get this value error right here. But what if I try to type in equals, and then let's say row 18 divided by 10, and I hit enter. I can see that that did calculate correctly. But then if I go over to row 18 and I highlight it and right click and go to delete, I now get a ref error. And that ref error happens because I used to reference a cell, but that cell is no longer there. So when I click on the ref error and I look up here in the formula bar, I can see the pound ref with an exclamation point. And then our third kind of error is just say I type equals this divided by zero and hit enter. You will now get the divided by zero error because you actually cannot divide any number by zero. So how do I go about trapping for these kinds of errors?
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Excel has a built-in function called IFERROR. So let's just take the divided by zero one right here as an example. So if I click back on here and I can see that I'm dividing by zero right here, and that is where my problem is. But let's say if instead of returning this kind of error, I would rather just have a zero here. If I click right before my formula in between the equal sign and my formula, and I type the word if error in a left parenthesis, the first argument that I will be prompted for is a value. And so I want Excel to evaluate this right here. And if this is a legitimate value, I want that value returned. But if I click to the end of my formula and I type a comma, I now have an argument for value if error. So in this case, I'd like to put a zero instead of pound divide by zero exclamation point. So then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. So now you can see that instead of getting that weird error, I'm now getting a zero. If I click back up here where I did value, I can also click right after the equal sign and do if error, left parenthesis. Let's leave this as my value. And then at the end, I'm just going to do comma zero again. So if I get an error, instead of getting pound value, I will now be returned with a zero. But let's go back here, C2. I'm getting an error because C2 is text. But what if I were to change C2 to the number 24? Now when I hit enter, if I look over here at cell K, I'm actually adding 12 to whatever is in this cell. And because I put a number in this cell, I am actually being returned with a value of 36 because 24 plus 12 is 36 and not the zero for my error trapping. But if I go back here and I put text back in and I hit enter, I'm now being returned with a zero because this is not something that 12 can be added to. And then for my cell reference, I think I want to caution you on using if error on the cell reference, because this kind of error is actually letting you know that you've deleted a cell and your formula has actually changed because it doesn't know what cell to reference. So you really do kind of want to go back and change this ref to be a cell so that Excel is not returning values that are very unpredictable to you. So I wouldn't really use if error on the ref error, but if you wanted to, you could just, again, type after the equal sign and type if error, left parenthesis, at the end of your formula, comma zero, right parenthesis, and hit enter. And you can trap for the ref error, but I just caution you against that, because the ref error really is just trying to let you know that you've really deleted a cell that's important to that formula. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction on some ways that you can use if error to do some error trapping inside of Microsoft Excel. Don't forget to check out our blog for more error trapping that you can do. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.